And of course, Sims is AFK.
Hey, there we go. Here we are for the biggest, the longest, the greatest race on the SCART schedule, the World 600. This is my Ken Squire voice. And run away. I'm going to stop that forever now, but it was fun. He's the first lap, but I'm going to wait after that. I'm going to try to keep up my trend where I have never been passed for position in this car. That's not going to happen because I'm not that good here. I'm good here. It's just hard to defend like that, especially with the draft. You can see burnout. Got a little bit of a run on me, and then he came flying at me. Actually, his fastest lap was faster than qualifying in the draft, and he's driving better. Oops. And rip the streak. Burn out some elbow room. It's my fault that he's not leading. Try to learn a bit about running in traffic, running in some dirty air, the draft as well. I can already see my problem for race pace is I'm gonna cut turn one too early, and it's gonna mess up my angle for turn two. I need to make sure I'm treating it like a double apex turn, taking a wide approach, using the banking, keeping up some speed, and then getting a good run off. That's what's going to be most effective for race pace in turn one and two. Three and four is pretty standard. Seems like it's a little bit easier. Oh shit. I just had a huge head of steam there and didn't get my car turned at all. Good to know that that happens. I don't think I really raced anybody that closely on 20% tire wear like this. Also looking like tire wear is pretty heavy, so it's gonna have an effect on strategy. I think the main thing is if you take the wide entry like you need to get the angle, you can really get sucked into the boost terrain, and it makes it so you have to brake a lot more than you feel like you need to if you take a more shallow entry. So you have to make sure the brake keeps crashing and getting nicely out of the way, so I appreciate that. But you have to really make sure that you're addressing which part of the track you're on as you're coming in to enter the corner, and making sure that you're braking the appropriate amount based on how much speed you have. Running well, he's still leading. I think everybody else has had an issue, gotten into the wall, but Sims seems to be keeping it pretty clean early on. Okay. Pulled up last there, so I let him go past and then gave him my speed, although it looks like I might get to him here. I think he was trying to give me the inside and I was trying to go to the outside. Had that happen before with Laffler. We just kind of have a miscommunication on where we're going. Not that either of us is doing anything wrong. It's just both trying to approach the situation opposite ways, and we end up running into each other because of it. bounce into the wall again. So that'll put me up to the second. Sim's still leading. And some early laps led. Trying to get some of those bonus points. Getting out of Deluxe's way, but it ended up just putting me right where he was trying to dodge me at, but I don't think it would have mattered either way. Either way, that put both of us a decent ways back. Turn 2 is deceptive. It's still got this. It's got the same shape that it always had. So you can still. Get sucked up into the outside. Oops. Like there, other than Sims, there were a lot of mistakes all the way around. I think with the it looks like Tronic pitted. All right. So yeah, it seems like there's more grip, and so especially early on in the run, it takes away a little bit of the typical Charlotte tendency where you slide up exiting turn two into the wall, but the tire wear is pretty severe, so it almost seems like everybody's misjudging it a little bit more than they otherwise would, because the track's changing so much, and you mix that with being in the draft and then dirty air versus being by yourself where you're going slower but you have more grip, and also with the way that the outside line is so strong, it kind of sucks you in. So with all that, you can have really different speed going into the corner, and then if you don't adjust appropriately, then it pushes you into the outside wall like it always did. So it's a little bit different, but kind of the results of it are the same. And it seems like, as usual, there's probably going to be a long run during this race. It usually is in the World 600, and you're gonna have to just be staying out of the wall. It's not gonna make much of a difference if you are a tenth faster here or there. It's gonna make a difference if you're not hitting the wall, because you lose, you know, 2 seconds every time you hit the wall. Nice one, Deluxe. All right. So, wait, Burnout got the lead on Pit Road. Okay. He's like, oh, Sims takes the inside, but he is the leader for the caution, not. Okay, that was different. Had a big run there and then really screwed up trying not to wreck the leaders. Expecting Sims to try to shoot that gap. I kind of got caught up there, and so that's gonna give Shemek a bit of an advantage. Down a bit. Whoa. Oops. That's an incredibly dumb mistake to make. Really feel when you're in a tight pack like this how much tighter this track is versus Texas. So much faster and so much looser that it ends up driving basically the same as Charlotte, because it's just an expanded version, but you're getting like the same lap times, the same everything. But the setup we've got, it feels a whole lot tighter. Back there. I thought the Sims might be trying to make a move on burnout, and so I didn't want to try to have all three of us go crazy into the corner or anything. Get that all sorted out long enough so we can keep going. Let's move to the fourth. I got Deluxe, Shaka, and Shemek up in front. Coming. Took that way too aggressively. It's a big wreck for a laugh, and then it got me caught up. Spread out into pit road here. Nah, it'll be fine. That'll put me fifth, right? Yep. Which is perfect. Sims AFK as usual. Sims is, of course, delaying proceedings to see who claimed the first seat in the election. That's what really matters, right? That was a bit of a clusterfuck, but we all get going. Shy guy wrecked in front of that whole snarling pack. Fortunately, Sims can avoid him. Oops. There. Saw him get going though. Yeah. Like at first it might be a lag out, but it can be hard to get back going after you do that. Oh. That was a bit crazy with lag. Looked like I hit him, then I looked like I didn't hit him. Wasn't sure where I was. Now we're good to go. So I'm back in the lead with the Lux behind me. It really helps to take a wide entry into turn one, and so it's really easy to get caught on the outside wall there in the front stretch. It's also really easy to clip the apron and be, well, pretty much screwed. Everybody pitted. Schumacher taking fuel only. Kind of overdid it into my pit stall there. Messed up burnout a little bit. But ended up okay. So Schumacher's on fuel only. We had, I think it was at 86% tires, something like that. Schumacher has been known for taking only fuel and then taking advantage of track position. Hashtag crash for lands. The top trending hashtag in North Korea. Alright, now we can restart. Alright. Try restarting from second place. It's an odd restart. I don't think I'll be able to learn much from that, but... stay out. I'll probably regret it, but whatever. Usually I try not to fuck around this early in the race, but whatever. Gotta get them bonus points. Looks like a couple took fuel only. And burnout just gave me full fuel. And this makes results slightly more difficult. It appears that I am the best at strategy. I stay out when I'm gonna get my fuel reset for free. Alrighty, here we go. Now we get to race the world 460 or something like that. After completing the world 140. Take two. Fastest lap under caution. Just barely clipped each other there. I think I would have had him if it went all the way, but just barely clipped each other. Did get the lap led at the line. Set my fastest lap of the whole sessions, all of the sessions, which is good. Crashing spectacularly and losing all of my track position is less good, but at least I got fastest lap. But I think Burnout's lap from part one of the race is faster anyway. FTR's nicely to the inside, easy to get around them, which is appreciate the courtesy. It's hard to get a feel for how aggressive you can be. This is a tough track to learn on as well. Thing is, once you get going to where you have good pace at Charlotte, you can apply what works here pretty much anywhere else, well, at least on all the ovals. So once you get pace here, you can have pace anywhere. But it is a difficult track to get the hang of. We are down to 20%. It was like I got the first whiff of dirty air and I just couldn't turn. Feeling pretty decent about race pace. It's just a matter of keeping it mistake free and then navigating traffic. I'm having troubles. It seems like pack's coming back to me. This Deluxe is a decent ways ahead. I haven't seen him, but caught Burnout and Sims here. Lap's not too far ahead. Stole Burnout speed there, but I had left like two lanes, so not much I can do. Someone's leaning on me. Getting to the point of the run where it's hard to keep your car down. Especially in dirty air. outside pass again. There's a couple times that hasn't worked out because that happened. Now if I get around Sims, I'll be fine. It's just a matter of getting around him. Time he cut me off on entry, and then I put him into the wall because he stole my speed on entry. But he cut off my line. I had nowhere to go. Was going on with Laugh there, but he went way up the track. That puts me in second. Seems like Laugh is, or Deluxe has set sail. I don't know what the gap is, but I can't even see him. Schemek was kind of out of the way, so I wonder if that was a lag for everybody. It's a pretty minor lag for me, the Sims pit. Maybe Schemek had just come out of the pits. That's a possibility. Is pretty heavy tire wear here. I don't like to mess around too much with strategy though in short pitting. We're starting to get a long run like this. If the caution comes out at the wrong time, you can really get screwed. If you're the only one who gets caught a lap down, then it's no big deal. That erases Deluxe's lead. I don't know how far ahead he was, but I didn't see what happened then. I guess if the server was the cause, then yeah. Alrighty. Decent timing all told, since we're getting to pretty close to green flag pit stops anyway. Renault gave me and Deluxe a huge boost there. Ah! Fuck. So I had to restart my tires there, so hopefully I won't lose too many spots. Just one. I'd rather be in third than second anyway. That's fine. Be right back. Yeah. If we went green, it would be a two-stop race from here. Not like we're gonna go green, let's be real, but two-stopper either way. 140-ish laps to go. Which would mean 46 lap runs if you did it, if you split it evenly. You probably want to pit at 132 to I guess the Lux went AFK real quick, figuring we weren't going yet. But now we are. Yeah, 138 laps to go. Big shove there from Shy Guy, which gave Deluxe a huge advantage. And he kind of overdrove it. That gave him the speed back. Through the middle here. A little bit crazy. Stuck in front of Deluxe a bit there, but I think I'd given him a lane and I was clear. God, I'm sorry. I'm gonna flicker lag right as that happened. I couldn't tell if he just kind of got into the back of me or if I got like, cut him off. I like driving in clean air better. Crash there. A bit of a mistake on exit there. That burn out close enough to get a sniff of some draft. We get slightly more flicker lags. Also, I'm not doing turn two very well in this amount of tires. I think that was hurting beforehand as well. That's really driving aggressive. More power to him if he can make that stick without crashing. Yeah, the double apex thing works on new tires, but it doesn't really work on old tires that well. Because you need as much momentum as possible, so it's better if you can get yourself a big run on the outside. Not with that though. Is definitely pretty strong here. And that was getting pretty good runs on me from far back. Once he gets right next to me, shit. It's the second time I've done that to burn out. decent advantage. Since I basically killed his whole lead that he should have had. You get right up on somebody, they take away your air and you slide more and you lose more speed out of it. So you can't get the run like you're getting. And you're at about this distance. Shy guy doing the straightaway wall hit. Classic Shy guy. That's a good way ahead. But I did get some clean air at least. Which is nice. That was perfect. Which gets a little scary. So scary that I messed up turn three. People crashing on the straights this race. This track is, this is a tough setup here. Hey, I pulled into my pit stall correctly. It's a miracle. Jack, I forgot a stall. So Shy Guy, I don't understand why he didn't go back and pit, because like, around like 30% fuel, if it goes green any amount, then it's pretty much screwed. Shy up front there. There's the caution. Couple taking fuel only. I'm gonna go for tires. Kinda taking the if you ain't first, your last strategy. Also, yeah, two people took fuel only, so I'd rather be third than try to screw around for second, so. Third with tires is good enough for me. So, I guess 50R still listening to the stream here. Yeah, so you can pit or take a lap, one or the other, on a caution, unless you're the lucky dog. If you're the lucky dog, you can do both or take two laps. It's like you get one freebie. You get one freebie if you're not the first car lap down, but if you are the first car lap down, you get two freebies essentially. I don't know if that explains it any better, but yeah. Them's the rules. Line there. Now, FTR is the first car lap down, so he can either get one back and pit, or not pit and get two laps back, which is probably the better strategy. Since we just pit a second ago. Looks like two are taking fuel only. Ah. I was hoping I could beat Deluxe there, but I fair played the pit road speed. That was all it took. Starting to get the hang of the rules. I know, I was totally confused my first couple of races. So, the rules are like a slightly less complicated version of NASCAR, but they're still a bit out there sometimes. So, not the easiest to learn. We got 94 laps to go. Should be an easy one stopper if it goes green from here. 47 and 47. Yeah, it's kind of funny that Sims is the one who causes the most delays for the Europeans who stay up late on weeknights to do this. Whereas the Americans, where it's just about 7 o'clock, we're pretty conscious of everybody else's time. That was a clusterfuck right there. And that nice split shy guy. And I took away Burnout's line. I threw all kinds of dirty air on him. Ended up getting into the wall. Wasn't exactly the nicest move, but you gotta do that on restarts. That's the difference between being in clean air like this with only one car behind you and being stuck in that pack and losing tons of time. So you gotta take the opportunities when they're there. Put this shy guy to the lead. Luckily I was far enough out from the big battles. Sims here, I'll be in basically clean air. Bad entry though. Hopefully I can clear in here. Better not decide to make it. Keep taking a shallow entry into three to make sure that when I was racing Sims, I kept taking a shallow entry into three to make sure he didn't make a dive on me, because my normal line's a pretty wide entry, but that every time I did, I completely screwed up my entry to the corner, and so he caught right back up to me. looks like everybody's back on the lead lap. We got 82 laps to go with the line. Starting to get down to some business here. Looks like I gave Burnout a big push there, so got the outside line going. Something, I didn't see something there. They called for a yellow, so I guess we're good. That's terrible. Alrighty, I just need to stop making moves into three. It's not working out for me very well. Trying to let him go. I guess he was alright with it. Kind of stole his speed, but I guess I'm faster than him at the moment anyway with his shit net, so makes sense to try to get away from each other. And he's covered by Sims and Chinook. Saw some shit happen, but didn't know how much of it can be fair played or what. If they don't call for it, I'm not gonna call it. I don't have a very good view. That's just driving away. Burnout reprofiled the track. He definitely made it to his liking. We got plenty of testing time on it, helping out F-tronic up to speed and making sure that the new version was okay, so you can tell he's far more comfortable with pushing than any of us are. He's got a better feel for the extremes. He's more interested in kicking it off the wall, to be honest. Very inopportune lie, but I thought it didn't have any major effects. Like he was hit it straight for the wall, but I guess he slammed on the brakes and saved it. Definitely going to be some varying pit strategies here. Do you try to cut the run in half, or do you lay it out for fuel mileage, for a full fuel run, and hope that you catch some people down the lap that try and stuff. Easy thinking about fuel, pit strategy. Also, if you ride it out, do you take tires or not? Third time that's happened. Fairness to me, he was just way out of control. Taking it super aggressive and didn't have time to dodge me. I stayed, well, as well out of the way as I could there. Now Shimek's right back in this battle. Since he had just pitted, but so theoretically, do it. Yeah, we left Sims. Oh. Theoretically, you can go to the end from here. this is going to be a total clusterfuck for doing results, because the race is in 3 segments. I'm probably gonna have to, we're gonna have to save a little bit of fuel here, so hopefully it doesn't come down to that shit. I'm sure we'll get a yellow before then. It's in 3 segments, and we've managed to tack on an extra lap, so it's now the Skart's world. Waste even more fuel. Fuck. Alright. 5% fuel should not. Okay, that might. That might do it for fuel, though. Try to set fastest lap for the 3rd time. So according to the fuel tracker, I should be good by like half a lap. Yeah. Thing is, once I lose some pace, I'll start coming back down, so to be cognizant of that if we go green. I'm guessing we won't go green and it won't matter. Probably run like 5 laps laying off the gas and that'll be enough to save it. Definitely as good as burnout on fresh tires. Once you get a little bit further into the run, he gets a little bit of an advantage, I think. Screw up and dirtier. Got tangled up there. It's gonna put Shaggy to the lead. Deluxe up to 2nd. Burnout back to 3rd. shot too. Crazy in front of me. I'm trying to save a little fuel while they're doing that because I figure I'm not going to pass all these guys anyway. I think that this is my opportunity to put some fuel in the bank in case I need it. Should have enough fuel in the bank at this point. I just gotta get back into a rhythm. I'm messing with my driving style there. Tires are worn out. Get back in the rhythm, catch back up to these guys. Going slow there. We're not a shy guy racing side by side up ahead. Maybe all I need to catch back up. Burnout's probably the fastest at this stage of the run. He has been. Past Shy Guy. It'll be a tough time for all of us, but if we keep racing, then he'll bring me and Deluxe right back into it. Still looking close on fuel. Shit. Gets into the walls, that makes it down to us three up here. Right on the edge of fuel. I can try to save, but I'm just gonna try to win the race, so I can't take myself out of contention, but keep his fuel saving. 13 to go at the line. Still right on the edge. We're starting to get a little bit closer to lap traffic as well. Run out into the wall. Sips of fuel there. Laps to go, 11 laps in the tank according to the thing. Which at 20%, that's about right. Time to go. crazy racing on these old tires like this. Jacket pushes me ahead. And he puts himself into the wall. Turns out plenty of room to save some fuel with six to go. Looks like burnout's falling back. Yeah, that Sim's directly behind me, so all I have to do is save fuel and keep it out of the wall. And yep, we'll get a 3-lap shootout here. Okay. Now will anybody be dumb enough not to pit? Tires. Got myself just a little bit of fuel. Alright, I'll be third, so that's good enough for me. Best spot on this restart, I think. Not sure what was going on there. You know what it's like driving on real tires? Pressure. There it is. Winner, winner. Shy guy with the fastest lap to end it. Nice. That was a janky restart. I'm not entirely sure what was going on there. Laugh kind of went a little early, and then I basically figured that if I push him ahead and made it down to me and him, that would be my best strategy. Nice. And so that worked because he was overdriving trying to defend against me, and he ended up getting into the wall out of four, so I just had to put together two clean laps, and at that point the field was so discombobulated that I didn't have much pressure. I'm excited for that one. Alrighty. Glad I got the win. It was tough racing, and I felt like I worked really, really hard to get it under green, and then we ended up getting the yellow. So I'm glad that the restart worked pretty well.
That'll do it. Thanks everybody for watching. Appreciate it, and I'll see you around next time.